Unfortunately, the trailer and publicity around it in New Zealand has misrepresented the Prime Minister's involvement in this project and caused confusion around the role of the Duke and Duchess. Ardern's chief press secretary emailed the Nelson Mandela Foundation in December. The press secretary said a media statement had been released to clarify that an interview with Ardern set to feature in the series was conducted years prior and not by the royal couple. The PMO was notified last year, after the interview was recorded in 2019, that Harry and Meghan were involved in the project. However, it never replied to that email, according to correspondence obtained by NewsHub. In a new statement to NewsHub, a spokesperson for the PMO said the foundation apologized for the confusion after the trailer was released. NewsHub has been told an email to the PMO from the foundation said it did apologize for the confusion that has arisen. But the Nelson Mandela Foundation has now told NewsHub it doesn't believe the trailer misrepresented Ardern's involvement. It's also said, understandings of what constitutes apology differ. In this instance, what we would call clarifications and acknowledgements were sought and communicated by all parties concerned. The trailer for the Live to Lead documentary series came out in mid-December last year ahead of the show's December 31st release on streaming giant Netflix. It promised the series would feature a star-studded lineup of interviewees, including Ardern, former U.S. Supreme Court Justice Ruth Bader Ginsburg, and climate activist Greta Thunberg, reflecting on their values and legacies. The Duke and Duchess of Sussex produced the series and appeared throughout the trailer speaking of how the guests are people who have made brave choices and inspired others. While the trailer quickly made global headlines, Ardern said she had had no clue she'd be showing up in a series presented by the royals when she sat down for her interview in 2019. It was intended initially as material for a short book and other resources being made by the Nelson Mandela Foundation for aspiring leaders around the globe. But in the years since the interview was filmed and permission for its use was granted by Ardern, the foundation had secured an agreement for Netflix to broadcast it. Prince Harry and Meghan Markle then became involved amid their foray into entertainment. The pair shocked the world in 2020 after ditching their senior royal roles and moving to the United States. There, they signed deals with the likes of Netflix and Spotify, and used interviews to criticize the British royal family and attack the media. At the same time, their personal popularity plummeted. The PMO first became aware of the royals' involvement in May last year when Vern Harris from the Nelson Mandela Foundation emailed with an update on the project. NewsHub has obtained that email and other correspondence under the Official Information Act, OIA. After discussing the challenges COVID-19 had presented and how the rollout of the project has been slower than originally planned, Harris gave the office a heads up about Harry and Meghan's involvement. It was called an exciting new dimension that Netflix had asked to remain confidential. We had an opportunity to share material from the interviews with the Sussexes in 2020 and as a result of feeling inspired by both the quality of the material and the importance of the message, they undertook to help open doors for Netflix to broadcast it, Harris said. He said the royals had agreed to record brief introductions for each episode in an effort to help the series reach the largest possible audience. The email ended with Harris saying, "Please let us know if we can tell you anything more about the project." Thank you. quality of the material and the importance of the message, they undertook to help open doors for Netflix to broadcast it, Harris said. He said the Royals had agreed to record brief introductions for each episode in an effort to help the series reach the largest possible audience. The email ended with Harris saying, "Please let us know if we can tell you anything more about the project."